This will be a demonstration on rigging equipment to install rigging equipment with all inspections to install an overhead transformer on a wood pole. And I'm going to be touching and handling equipment, so I've got to have all my personal protective equipment on. I'm going to do a self-check that I have everything in place, start from head to toe, hard hat, safety glasses, chin strap, leather gloves, proper clothing, proper footwear. And then I'm going to start with my inspections. First, I'm going to inspect my roadblocks, the general condition of the roadblocks, the keepers, all the safety gates. These roadblocks are in good shape. The WWL, which is the weight rating on them, is 1,400 pounds. I'm going to check the rope. Rope is good. No tears, no cuts. Everything looks good. That knot's good. Then I'm going to inspect my tagline rope. Make sure that the knots are good. No tears, no cuts, no real abrasion, just general wear. That rope's in good shape. Next, I'm going to check my rigging rope, which will be tied up on the pole to rig my roadblocks in. Looking at that rope, that rope is in good shape. Check this rope. That will be the rigging rope that will be tied to the transformer. All good here. Very good there. Next, I'm going to check my hand line, which will be used to bring materials up aloft while I'm on the pole. Taking a look at the hand line, all the knots. Look at the gate on the hand line hook. Everything's good there. My keeper is in there. No cuts, no tears, just general wear on that rope. Here I got a splice in the rope. Gonna take a look at that splice. That splice is good. Take a look at the handline snap. Got a chain link here. That chain link is nice and tight. Snap's working properly in the hook. And here's another chain link. Everything's good. Everything is good there. So now I will begin the demo on how to actually rig this on the pole, and then I'll go aloft and do everything aloft. So one of the first things I want to do is go ahead and get my transformer rigged. This is a tag line which will help pull the transformer out and keep it from twisting when we pull it up. So we're gonna do a knot here. It's called a round turn with three half hitches. While I'm tying these knots, I'm going to check how much the transformer weighs. It's important to know what you're lifting. Take a look. It has a material nameplate. All that information is on the material nameplate. This transformer weighs 194 pounds. Roadblocks are good for 1,400, so you see we have a lot of safety factor there. So this rope would be rigged on top of the transformer, and this rope would be where you would connect the roadblocks to pull it up, to place it on the pole. Using a square knot, and you can see I cross the rope. It just keeps it in place better, and I kind of test it, make sure the knot's okay. You see, I pull on this one, make sure the knot's okay, and then. The next thing I would do is rig my hand line. This will be the steps that I would do aloft. You want to make sure that the gate on your hand line block is up. It protects the gate. And then you just rotate it around out of your work area. Next, I would install my rigging rope above the hand line. And everything has to be kept under positive control. When I start climbing, you'll see I don't throw any straps. Everything is passed around hand to hand. Same way with this rope. So I'm gonna take this rope around, keep it totally under control. Secure one end of it. And I like going top, bottom to top. Yeah, I think it just works a little better. It's important to control everything. This will be a de-energized demo, but if you're working in energized conductors, you must keep everything under positive control. So you come back around, minimum 5 wraps is what we're looking for here. Again, using a square knot, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, checking. Everything's good. And you can actually straighten this rope out. And if you gotta move it around or whatever you need to do with it, you can actually move it a little bit, okay? Next step would be install my roadblocks. The critical step is make sure this is called a fall line. That fall line has to be at the top. So grab your roadblocks in this manner, take them, and you can work it right up through those ropes, one at a time. Then gate out. Here again, when you connect them up, we want to be consistent on the way we do things. With attention to detail, make sure gate's out down here. And what's going to happen, ground personnel will pull the transformer up and we would install it on a boat.